little bit of stretching, a little bit of movement, a little bit of breath, and then we'll get you on your way. So once you're ready to begin, find a comfortable seat, rooting down through the sit bones, crossing the ankles if that feels comfortable. Hands can rest anywhere that you'd like. Elbows are gonna be nice and heavy here. Start softening through the shoulders, reaching up through the crown of the head, and then maybe closing the eyes. We'll take a few breaths here just to welcome ourselves to the practice. Connect to the present moment, letting go of anything that's happened thus far. Letting go of any expectations for the rest of our day. And simply staying here, connected to our breath, to our experience right here, right now. You can begin to flutter the eyes open. Starting with some side bends, so taking that right hand out to the right, big side bend here with the left arm up and over. Coming back to center, other side. And we'll do that one more time. Tilting over to the right. And to the left. Good. Coming back to center, taking a twist. So left hand over to the right knee. Right hand reaches behind you. Inhale, lift and lengthen. On the exhale, really feel that twist, upper body towards the right. Two more breaths. You're gonna take this right hand and lift it all the way up and over so that it crosses over the left. And then take your eagle arms here. Hands away from the face, elbows lifted to about shoulder level, and hold. So you're creating some tension here between the arms in order to broaden through the upper back. Two more breaths. Good, and then release the arms out to the sides. Let's take the twist on the other side. So right hand to the left knee. Left hand behind you. Big breath in, lengthen. Exhale, deepen that twist. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, twist. One more. And then taking that left arm all the way up, over, crossing it over the right, and then taking your eagle arms here. If this is not a comfortable variation, you're always welcome to reach for opposite shoulders. Just keep the elbows lifted as you would in a full bind. Two more breaths. Good, we're gonna unwind, reach the arms out in opposite directions, make fists with your hands, and then just roll out those wrists. Other direction. Good, reach the arms all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. And this is where we start transitioning over to tabletop. So make your way over to hands and knees. You wanna stack the shoulders about over the wrist creases, or maybe a little forward of them. Hips over the knees. I'm gonna tuck my toes under. You're welcome to keep them untucked. Nice and easy cat-cows here. Dropping the belly, looking up, shoulders away from the ears. Exhale, round the spine, tuck chin to chest. Inhale, dropping the belly, looking up. Exhale, round. Inhale, drop belly, look up. Exhale, round. Good. Pause here, nice neutral flat back. Inhale, right arm up towards the ceiling, going to our thread the needle. Threading right arm underneath the left, dropping all the way to the right shoulder, right ear. Left hand can reach forward or behind your back. Make your way back.
movement here, trying to open up through the soles of the feet, waking up the toes. And then come back into your tabletop. Lift the left arm up towards the ceiling, and then thread through. Left arm under right, all the way down to the left shoulder, left ear. Right hand can stay here, reach forward, or behind your back. Keep fueling the body with that breath. And then make your way back to your tabletop. Toes curled under this time, up and back, downward facing dog. So start lifting those knees and then lifting all the way up to your down dog. Bending one knee and then the other, shaking head side to side. Find movement here that feels good. Imagine this is the first time you've ever done down dog. So you really want to find the right distance between hands and feet, shoulders, hips. Yeah. And then when you're about good, bend those knees a little more so you really send the sit bones up and back, find length through the spine. Big breath in through the nose. Open your mouth, let it go. Slowly start stepping forward. Forward fold at the top of your mat here. Bend your knees. Ooh, this was an interesting choice of shirt for this particular practice. Grab onto opposite elbows, relax head and neck, sway side to side. Feel weight both on the toe mound side of your feet and the heels. Right and left. Find center. Relax even more. Knees stay bent. Bring weight towards the heels as you start lifting all the way up. Reach up. Look up. Take it right back down, forward fold. Halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold. Step your right foot back. Blocks can be really helpful here if you have them as we work in our low lunge. Keep the right knee lifted and then relax shoulders away from ears. Now slowly begin to straighten that left leg. So taking it back to more of a runner's lunge. See if you can fold a little more deeply over that left leg. Bend back into the left knee, plant through the right, easy twist. Keeping both hips lifted and even, shoulders away from ears. Left hand comes back down to the mat. Step back to plank. Really hold here, hugging that belly button up and in, kind of puffing up the upper back as you press away from the mat. And then lower the knees, untuck toes, lower all the way down to the belly. Reach the heart forward. As you reach the forearms forward, settle into Sphinx Pose. Gently lower all the way down. Hands beneath the shoulders to lift up and back. Find a child's pose. So widen the knees, toe mounts touch. Take the hips back towards the heels and release. Walk the hands as far to the right as possible. So really finding length here through the left side of the ribs. Keep pressing down through the left side. Back to center, other side. Reach as far to the left as possible, emphasizing that length in the right side. Right sit bone presses down. Back to center. Begin to make your way to downward facing dog here. Take your time, curling the toes under, lifting the knees, the hips, up and back. Big length here in the back. Big breath in through the nose. Let it go. Make your way back up to the top of your mat. Forward fold.
option for blocks here. Step back with the left foot. Finding that low lunge, really finding length to that left hip flexor. So it's more of a cow spine here instead of just rounding. So shoulders away from ears. The back of the neck stays long. So your gaze is about a foot in front of you. Mouth, eyes, tongue, cheekbones, everything else relaxed. Begin to straighten through that right leg. Ooh, hello. Hello, stretch. Bend back into the right knee. Easy twist here. So plant left hand, reach up through the right. Right hand comes down. Step back to your plank pose. Good. Hold here. Another big breath in. On the exhale, drop the knees down, untuck the toes, lower all the way down to the belly. Drag the heart forward, Sphinx pose. Good. Slowly lower down. Hands underneath the shoulders. Lift up and back to your child's pose. Walk hands towards the right. Back to center, walk hands towards the left. Back to center, lifting back to downward facing dog. Big breath in, big breath out. Look between the hands, make your way all the way up to the top of your mat. Inhale to standing, sweep up, find length. Exhale, melt it down, forward fold. Halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold. Step your right foot back, straighten through the left leg. Bend back into the left knee, this time sweep up into high lunge. Settle here, soften the shoulders. Make sure that left knee is stacked over the ankle. Open up warrior two. Stacking shoulders over hips. Gaze is over that front left hand. Flip the palm, reach up and back. Reverse the warrior. Good. Cartwheel hands down towards the mat. Lift the left hand up towards the ceiling. Easy twist. Left hand down inside of the left foot. Wide-legged forward fold. Make your way there. And release. Ha. Walk back towards your front left foot. Step back to plank. Now, yogi's choice here, you can drop the knees, move through cobra or sphinx back to down dog, or full on chaturanga, upward facing dog. And then downward facing dog. Totally up to you. Take what serves you and leave the rest. Soften those knees, look forward, step or hop to the top of your mat. Inhale all the way up to standing. Last time, melt it forward. Halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold, step that left foot back, and then straighten through the right leg. Bend back into the right knee, sweep up, high lunge, soften shoulders. Opening up warrior two. Strong foundation here, weight on both feet, not just the front right foot. Flip front palm, reverse, find length. Cartwheel the hands down towards the mat. Easy twist, right hand up towards the ceiling. Right hand down inside of the right foot as you transition to your wide-legged forward fold. Soften here, fully and completely. and then walk back to your right foot. Last flow here, of course, it's optional. Stepping back to plank, chaturanga,
upward facing dog.
We'll all meet in downward facing dog. Bend those knees, really lengthen through the spine. Take in a deep breath.
Let it go.
Walking your way all the way up to the top of the mat. And this time dropping down to your booty and lowering all the way onto your back. Let's take a few moments here just to soften through the shoulders. Let the whole length of your spine melt onto the mat. All right, three bridge poses here. Nice and slow. Make sure your feet are hip width distance. The heels are close enough to your glutes so you can use the strength of your legs to lift. Here we go. Begin to press down, curl the pelvis up, 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 up. And gently bring it down. Again, inhale, curling up. Lifting the hips, lift, keep the knees pointing straight forward. And release. Last one. And release. All right, friends, knees in towards the chest. Give yourself a nice rock side to side. We'll finish with supine twist to each side. This, at least for me, it's a very delicious pose. So open the arms out and let the knees gently fall towards the right. Settle here, allowing the left shoulder to feel nice and heavy. You can look straight up or to your left. You can keep the eyes open or closed. Slowly making your way back to center, maybe layer here, lengthen out through your tailbone, and then let the knees drop towards the other side. Again, settling here, finding stillness, savoring stillness. Center. Settle in for Shavasana. Do not cheat yourself out of this pose. This is actually the most important part of the whole practice. So go ahead and find length here through the body. Take as much space as you need. Allow the toes to roll open and then surrender fully and completely here. Allow the breath to soften. Become smooth and fluid. And see if you can anchor your mind on that inhale and exhale, staying really connected to your experience of this practice till the very last minute. bringing more energy, more prana. Get ready for your day. And on the next inhale, go for that full body stretch, finding as much length as you can. Pointing through the toes, lifting up through the fingertips. And releasing, rolling over to your right or left side, whichever one you like most. With as little effort as possible, make your way back to a seat on your mat, just like we started, maybe that cross-legged seat with the sit bones rooting down, hands gently resting on the knees. Lengthen up through the crown of the head. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to your belly. Know that no matter how crazy your day gets, you can always return right here to your center. Give yourself the gift of stillness and breath anytime you need it. Don't forget, you totally got this. Hands to heart center, have a kick-ass day. I believe in you. Thank you so much for sharing this time with me, and I'll see you soon. Namaste.